Since the inception of space race, every country tried to seek life in another universe and another planets. That includes the solar system planets and their moons. In 1960s, during the time of Cold War, two superpowers, USA and the USSR, sent various probes to other planets and the moons. In 1969, July 20, the NASA sends first human being to moon. That is regarded as an one small step for a man and one giant leap for mankind. On December 15, 1970, Soviet Union sends Venera 7 probe to Venus to examine the atmosphere and the gaseous pressure of the Venus. That was another big step because the Venus is a planet itself and the hottest among all the other planets in our solar system. Since then, NASA, in true sense, took the giant leap to discover the life within our solar systems and other solar system by examining exoplanets. So, in seeking of life and the other knowledges about Saturn and its moon, NASA sends Cassini-Huygens in collaboration with European Space Agency and Italian Space Agency on 15th October 1997. Within that mission, the Saturn's moon Enceladus has become an alien hunting hotspot because Cassini found both active geysers and the liquid oceans beneath its frozen surface. The icy moon, one of the likeliest places to encounter the extraterrestrial life in our solar system. So let's talk little about the Enceladus briefly. What is Enceladus itself? Some of the facts about the Enceladus we will going to talk about in this point. The Enceladus is the sixth largest moon of Saturn. The Enceladus is mostly covered by fresh water, clean ice, make it one of the most reflective bodies of solar system because of having highest albedo. Enceladus was discovered on August 28, 1789 by William Herschel. But little was known about it until two Voyager spacecraft, Voyager 1 and Voyager 2, flew by Saturn in 1980 and 1981. Enceladus is complex geologically. Its surface have gone through five distinct evolutionary periods. In 2005, the spacecraft Cassini started multiple close flyby of Enceladus. In those close flybys, Cassini revealed its surface and environment in great detail. Cassini confirmed that Enceladus is still geologically active because this moon have water-rich plumes venting from the South Pole region. Cryovolcanoes near the South Pole shoot geysers like jets of water vapor, molecular hydrogen, ice particles and other materials into space. Some of the water vapor falls back as snow. The rest escapes and supplies most of the material making up the Saturn's E-ring. Now we are very much interested to know about the E-ring. What is E-ring? The Saturn's E-ring, a tenuous ring of micrometer size particles of water ice condensed from vapor ejected by these geysers, the geysers in the south poles of Enceladus. The E-ring particles are densest near the Enceladus orbit. And this ring is analogous to clouds of orbiting particles ejected from Jupiter's volcanically active moon Io. The E-ring, however, appears to be much more extensive, reaching out to the orbit of Rhea and perhaps beyond. The orbital lifetime of E-ring particles are very short, perhaps only 10,000 years. Now, we will going to talk about the possibility. The exhilarating question is how could the Enceladus possibly host the life? What is the reason behind of hosting the life? Why the scientist from the Earth? Actually, they are talking about the life existence within the Enceladus deep sea. As I already told you that the Enceladus South Pole has plume, and those plume ejected water, ice, and various other gaseous and other molecules, gaseous molecules. And there is more than just water, ice in plume. Among those gases that plume ejects, the Cassini found dehydrogen. and the variety of the carbon-containing compounds, including methane. What is particularly intriguing to the biologist are the presence of the dehydrogen and the methane, because the hydrogen is likely produced the interactions of the rock and the hot water on the Enceladus seafloor. The scientists have said, also suggesting that the moon has deep sea hydrothermal vents, the type of environment that may have been life's cradle here on Earth, just like we are seeing this kind of things under the ring of under the Pacific Ocean within the ring of fire, the way the Earth recycles, where the oceans recycles, how the life can exist within the deep oceans. In addition, the hydrogen provides the energy from Earth microbes that produce methane from carbon dioxide in a process called the methanogenesis. Sometimes similar could be happening on Enceladus, especially given that the Cassini also spotted carbon dioxide. The methane itself is a surprising bounty in the Saturn's moon with the water ice. The Enceladus has water, organics, and energy sources. These three ingredients are important to support the life here in Earth. If the organics, the probable organics, are there in Enceladus, then the life is possible over there in Enceladus. The Enceladus has sufficient amount of these materials. That is why the scientists have come to a conclusion that Enceladus might have the life within its deep oceans, the oceans under the cover of the ice. As I said, the moon has ocean, then what is the moon is like? What is its ocean like? So it must be very dark ocean, because it is covered all the way around by roughly 20 kilometer ice cap, though ice cap thickness is half of its pole, half at its poles. The ocean in Enceladus is 40 kilometer deep at an average, which is vastly deeper than the Earth's deepest ocean trench, the Mariana Trench. The presence and the temperature differences between the Enceladus ocean floor and the ocean ice cap must be tremendous. The salinity of the ocean's deep around the ice varies tremendously. So Enceladus have an ocean, but that ocean is very dark. And as if the ocean is very dark, that is why the life over there doesn't have the eye, because they do not have to see. We are seeing these kind of things in the Pacific Ocean's deep. There are so many creatures, those who cannot see, but that they can hunt by using the other organs. Maybe Enceladus have this kind of lives. So these kind of lives are possible over there in Enceladus. As if we are talking about the ice and the carbon dioxide, methane, maybe the life over there is very, very complex, maybe very easy. We do not know. Though after Cassini's path-breaking discovery, there have been a couple of proposals in the recent years, including the Enceladus Life Finder and the Enceladus Life Signature and Habitability. The Enceladus is one of the targets for scientists to find the life. Because life exists over here, then the human will come to know the proper life cycling during the Earth Ice Age. Although Enceladus temperature is -201 degrees centigrade during noon, and ice age temperature of Earth was around -44 degrees centigrade at an average, it will actually help the scientist and the biologist to draw a life analogy. We compare our free energy elements to ecosystem to Earth and determine that overall our values for both aerobic and the anaerobic metabolism meet or exceeds minimum requirements. This results indicates that oxygen productions and the oxidation chemistry could contribute to supporting the possible life, and the metabolically diverse metabolical or the microbial community on Enceladus. We are saying that because of the molecules hydrogens, because of the molecular hydrogen presence in the plume, indicates that the free energy is available in the ocean of Enceladus. So the life in Enceladus ocean might be complex or very, very easy because of the huge pressure and the temperature differences. So we do not know that what kind of life that Enceladus have. Maybe very complex, maybe very easy, because over here the human life is supported by the earth, atmosphere and the so many other variable things. So maybe Enceladus do not have that kind of atmosphere and the temperature, but the life could be possible under the deep oceans within the huge pressure and the temperature differences. Now we have reached our question part. The first question is, which of the following phenomenon cannot be observed on moon? The first is rising and setting of sun, solar eclipse, the motion of comets, twinkling of stars. The second question is, which space probe observes Jupiter's moon's Io in detail? First is Galileo, second is Cassini-Huygens, third is Voyager 1, fourth is Voyager 2. Thank you very much. Thank you for your attention.